Hello and welcome to the new series of Drishti IAS. I am Pooja Divedi, and in this segment today we are going to discuss about artificial intelligence versus human beings. This topic is important from the perspective of prelims and also from the perspective of GS Mains Paper 3. So let's begin with the topic. Why in news? Now this topic is in the news because a Nobel-winning scientist, Daniel Kahneman, has said that humans don't stand a chance against artificial intelligence. So while if we compare artificial intelligence with human beings, artificial intelligence works tirelessly and they will outwork human beings. Human beings, on the other hand, have the drawback of their sheer physicality. We are bound by certain negativities. So this is a danger that is lurking in the dark, according to the scientist. So if we talk about artificial intelligence, it describes the action of machines accomplishing tasks that have historically, remember this word, required human intelligence. So whatever was under the control of human beings, human intelligence, now can be accomplished by machines. I'm going to give you a very simple example. If you use YouTube, you use Facebook and Twitter, and also search through Google, through different portals such as Flipkart, Amazon, if you search for a certain commodity you want to purchase on Google, you would see, you would notice that that is recommended or suggested on your YouTube portal or WhatsApp through ads. This is what artificial intelligence is. This is what the nexus between the different social media and other platforms are. And another thing, if you have bought that, a similar object will be shown to you at any next turn. So this is artificial intelligence. If you listen to music or watch movies on Netflix and listen to music on YouTube, they will suggest you a certain genre, that particular genre that you are used to, time and again, because they have understood how your brain works, and accordingly they suggest you. That makes your life easy, isn't it? So this is artificial intelligence. It includes technologies like machine learning, pattern recognition, big data, neural networks, and self-algorithms. It also involves complex things such as feeding a particular data into the machine and making it react as per different situation, that is machine learning. It is basically about creating self-learning patterns where the machine can give answers to the never answered questions like humans would ever do. The confusion that exists between artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning is that artificial intelligence is an umbrella term. It is a technique which enables machines to mimic human behavior. This is a bigger term. And it engulfs machine learning. Machine learning is a subset of AI techniques which use statistical methods to enable machines to improve their experience. They will be fed information, and according to the information they get, they will try to react in a way. And once that reaction is acceptable according to the machine, then they will continue to react the same way in same situation, but that needs different experiences. And deep learning is something that is a subset of machine learning that comes under machine learning, which makes computation of multi-layer neural network feasible. That means deep learning means it will keep on engaging through machine learning. It will keep on accumulating layers of information. All right, let's move on and talk about how AI is helping in the fight against COVID throughout the world. Artificial intelligence application for COVID-19 pandemic. This has been published to show how artificial intelligence worked through the times of COVID, so such as detecting COVID early. Now, how is that possible? AI can be used to detect and treat the disease early. For example, an AI-based diagnostic kit, instead of taking a sample from the nasal swab, uses a chest X-ray or breath odor. Now, because AI can actually detect the difference in the breath or odor of a COVID patient and a non-COVID patient, and that has helped in several countries, helping in outbreak mapping, such as Canada's Blue Dot. Canada's Blue Dot, actually, in the year 2019 itself, in the Hubei province of China, it suggested about an outbreak. Even in India also it suggested, and in many other regions of its own country, that means Canada. So it helped in the outbreak mapping so that we can be prepared. According to leading medical journal, The Lancet, applying artificial intelligence to the current pandemic could help in predicting the location of the next outbreak. From making vaccines to genome sequencing. Genome sequencing is sequencing the genome structure of the virus in order to understand what it is capable of. What variants can it turn into? How many mutations or what is the speed of its mutation? So that is very important. And sequencing of the virus, creation of mRNA vaccines are all happening using the processes of in silico design, which is fundamentally one of the sisters of artificial intelligence. It also is helping with the vaccination drive, right? And AI can also play a role since it is taking decision on an optimum basis by considering the complex interplay of vaccination goals. What is the supply going to be? What is the demographic of an economy and everything? Also helping hospitals to plan better and reduce human interaction through many apps and portals. Moving on, let's talk about artificial intelligence and India. According to a Canada-based company's report, Global AI Report 2019, India stood at the 9th position in terms of the number of AI specialists working in the field. The US, China and UK top the list. If we talk about the importance of artificial intelligence in India during the times of COVID, we could not experiment much, while China did a lot. And according to a government spokesperson, it was said that Arogya Setu was one of the experiments, but it had faced so much retaliation from the common people in terms of privacy, which was actually an issue. That is the reason India could not go on with such experiments or rolling out of artificial intelligence as China did, because China has a different political structure there, which is not acceptable in India. So, the CBSE has AI as an elective subject for its 9th grade classes, and IIT Hyderabad has launched a full-fledged Bachelor of Technology program in AI, becoming the first Indian educational institute to do so. Defense Forces of India are now venturing into the products and technologies which will aid defense measures using the AI and technologies, and corporates have also started collaborating with academia on AI. There are many startups in the country which are doing great work in image analytics, data analytics and predictive intelligence. And it is estimated that AI will add $957 billion to India's GDP by the year 2035. Moving on, let's talk about the certain advantages, such as making policies. India still has a conventional policy. AI-based products open a new window of opportunity for better policy making, because data would be more creatively collected, data would be created more robustly, more precisely and more specifically, so that categorization could be done of data and accordingly the policies could be rolled out. In agriculture, it has many uses. For example, it can help sense on how much water the crop needs so that we can go ahead with precision irrigation and also precision fertilization, everything. For solving complex issues like efficient utilization of available resources and analyzing the data. The AI technology helps in analyzing the data and can thus improve the efficiency of the systems like power management in cars, mobile devices, weather predictions, video and image analysis. Let's talk about the disadvantage. The biggest disadvantage is on the privacy, because India does not have a very robust and clear-cut data protection bill. The right to privacy is under threat. Technological unemployment in the sense, as we all know, that we still have a huge population of unskilled labors and semi-skilled labors. If AI comes into the picture more extravagantly, those people will be pushed out of the employment of the economy. And that will create a lot of problem for India. It could become a demographic challenge for India. Disproportionate power and control over data. More and more, any company or any country accumulates the data, the more powerful it becomes. And this could lead to an unequal balance of power. Security is a critical aspect. If somebody compromises a smart system, for instance, an autonomous car, the consequences can be disastrous, particularly given the ever-increasing cybersecurity threat. And lethal autonomous weapon. In a military context, this autonomy in decision making becomes very scary, right? Because robots to be used as a part of the future is something to be thought about right now. Let's talk about the conclusion. Now, AI technological revolution, it brings great opportunities and also risks. But it has to be ensured
that the technology will be applied and used in the right direction, ethically. It can also be said that AI may suffer from what is known as AI effect or the odd paradox. AI brings a new technology into the common fold. People become accustomed to this technology and it stops being considered artificial intelligence and newer technologies emerge. Thus, we can conclude that the growth of AI and AI-based applications should not be halted, but its growth and usage should be monitored and regulated at various levels respectively. Let's move on to our questions for Means. Technology in itself is value neutral. It's the structure of the society that guides its direction. In this context, critically discuss the scope of artificial intelligence in society. So, that's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again with another segment. Until then, stay updated and thank you so much for watching.